Lizzie, yeah, don't worry, just carry the tray, will you?
Yes, Mr. Faulkner. G'day, lager. There's no way out, Doc. You've had it this time. Now, supposing you tell me exactly what happened to Edwards. A sort of deathbed confession.
Oh, you're mad. I told you I did nothing to her.
What about the knife?
Well, I found it by the rubbish bin.
Ben.
You're lying, Doc. And it's not going to get you anywhere at all. You see, I'm going to kill you for lagging. Not for getting rid of Edwards. You did me a favour by doing that. I'm just curious about how you did it.
I'll scream. The officers will come.
Oh, they're tied up in the dining room. By the time they get here, we'll be gone and you'll be slightly dead.
No!
Don't let me interrupt. That's pretty smart of you, Brian.
Judy, for God's sake!
You realise, of course, if you kill her, you'll have to kill me too.
What?
You heard me. And oh, I'll put up a lot stronger fight than she does. Now, that's going to be pretty hard to explain to the screws, isn't it? Two dead bodies and the three of you with your faces smashed in. Of course, you could ignore me. But then I'll go straight to the governor and I'll tell her everything I've seen.
You know what happens to laggers?
Yeah, well, like you said, the sting of a dog wears off.
You fat bitch!
You listen to me, mate. I've already told you that I'm fed up to here with your petty squabbles. Now, if you want to do that, you do it somewhere else, because you're not doing it here.
Let's get out of here. You keep, Peterson. You keep. Get out.
Thank God you arrived in time.
In time for what?
What's that for?
Closest thing I've got to a life insurance policy in here.
If I'd been half an inch closer, I'd be suffering concussion by now.
And there was no cause, no provocation?
Mrs. Davidson, I have better things to do with my time than harass Peterson.
Of course, I wasn't suggesting that. I can just see no reason why she would do it.
Gave a usual excuse of the women being out to get her. No one else in the block. I'm beginning to think your suggestion of paranoia isn't too far wrong.
Where is she now?
I took her straight to solitary. Do you want to see her?
Oh, I can't see the point. We're not likely to learn anything new. I'll sign the charge sheet. She can be released tomorrow morning.
Right. Thank you.
As a tucker.
Edible. Just.
Oh, good. Then we'll all have some. Yeah. And you can be the waitress. Go and get us four plates of food now.
I don't think she heard you, Murray.
I heard her.
Well, you better get moving, hadn't you?
You're not helpless, Winter. Get it yourself.
You're in enough strife, Peterson. Now go and do as you're told, or I might have to deal with you before I'm good and ready. Go and get us four plates of food now.
You heard her, Winter. Get it yourself.
Well, I'm bugging. Good old bee. Now you'll see the sparks fly.
What's the matter, Murray? You're going to be pale. Lost your appetite?
Not me. But you might, Navani, when you find out about the changes around here.
You mean like you being top dog? Well, thanks for keeping my place warm for me, but now you can crawl back under your rock.
I'm on top, Smith, and I'm going to stay that way.
Well, you might like to try it, but you'll need plenty of muscle to support you.
I got the muscle all right, haven't I, girls?
Oh, you mean Laurel and Hardy? You've got to be kidding. And what about you, Margot? Haven't you got something else to do?
Sure, B. Whatever you say.
Oh, well, now I've done my good deed for the day and saved you from the Wicked Witch of the North. How about getting me some lunch? See, Murray? That's how it's done. Just haven't got the right neck.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. The Long Ranger couldn't have timed that better.
Looks like I arrived in the nick of time, Tonto. I believe Mari's been giving everyone a hard time.
Yeah, I think she's running for Dictator of the Year award. She's come down on all of us like a ton of bricks. We're all too scared to make a move.
You scared?
Well, you know how us Indians like to keep the peace, Kimasabi.
Tell me, what about her?
Her? Well, she's just got out of solitary, but there's trouble brewing. Mari's got her earmarked. That's just a matter of time.
Well, Winter will have to stand in a queue. What I don't understand is why Sandy didn't step in and stop all this. If anyone was going to take over, I figured it'd be her.
Haven't you heard?
Well, heard what? Now, come on, Jude. What's all the mystery?
Well, she's gone.
Gone? You mean escaped?
That's the official story, but some of us don't believe it.
What do you mean?
Well, she just disappeared. You know, I mean, literally disappeared. One minute she was there, the next minute she was gone. Now, Kate was the only one with her when she disappeared, and she claims she escaped.
Oh, did she now?
Yeah, and Maury reckons that somehow Kate killed her and got rid of the body.
Poor Sandy. I wouldn't put anything past Peterson. But if it's true, she's pushing her luck.
Yeah, well, now you know why Maury has it in for her.
Well, Maury's had to wait her turn. I have my own plans for Dr. Peterson. Looks like the doctor's found a foolproof way of getting out of here.
Aye?
Well, she needs some food soon. She'll be able to slip out under the front gate.
Yeah. Well, her hearing's in 2 days, so I expect she's a bit worried. Mm. Well, what are you going to do about it, Ben?
We'll find out about it when it happens.
Well, you better hurry up, or Mari will beat you to it. She's been giving her a real hard time lately.
Yeah, bit of a worry, that. Chuck, do me a favour tomorrow.
Oh, as long as you don't ask me to steal anything, it's against me religion.
Oh, I didn't know you were religious, Lizzie.
Yeah? Well, I had to chuck it in when they wouldn't let me be Pope.
Mouse, why don't you go and write a letter or something? I'd like to speak to Lizzie.
What? Oh, yeah, okay, B.
Fair dinkum. She's as thick as 2 short planks. What do you want me to do, love?
What? You reckon you can lay your hands on some old newspapers?
Oh, yeah, there are lots of them in the workshop. How many do you want?
Not many. Just the ones with something about Kate's trial in them.
What do you want to do with those?
Sorry, love, I can't tell you. Just trust me, eh?
All right.
Peterson, you wandered in the interview room. How come she gets a visit at this hour?
It's a legal visit, her solicitor. Is that okay by you? May we go?
Yeah, go right along.
Thank you.
For all the good it'll do her.